Hello everyone, Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. May we always be given more health and sustenance from God. My name is Muhammad Nanda Safa Adami. I will answer question from a given case. The case is, you are a researcher studying the effect of the climate change on the polar bears. You have found two studies that seem to contradict each other. One study found that polar bear population are declining, while the other study found that they are stable. How would you evaluate the evidence from these two studies? What factor would you consider in determining which study is the more credible? In this case, I will give my answer or my personal answer, my personal opinion about it. In this case, the two things are contradictory. One study found that the polar bear population were declining, while another study found that they were stable. To evaluate which of these two cases is true, I will conduct a likely research on this matter. By using research methodology that will compare the two cases, it can be seen through the method of collecting a large and concrete data and statistical analysis. The data that will be taken is of course from the source that, in my opinion, my personal opinion, can be used as a comparison to make a report or to make I can think this is the best data that I can use. Not only from the website that discussing these matters, but from research journal related to polar bear or reports that relate to polar bear population. When all the data has been collected, in my opinion, it's quite a lot. Of course, it's quite a lot. It will go into statistical analysis. After doing this, to maintain overall quality of my research, I will review every existing research from the data to existing report. So I will make a report to help me what I research of. For the credibility of the data source that will be used, I usually prefer to retrieve the data from a journal that has been published or website or reports that's often open source. By looking at the date of it, so that the data used is the latest data from the research. For climate and weather issue, I will take some example in Indonesia. In Indonesia, there is such thing as BMKG, Meteorology, Climatology, and Geophysics Agency. Why do I retrieve data from that place? Because the place is government agency. I think it's government agency that research the weather and climate in Indonesia. Climate change that is happening can make the population of the polar bear increasingly threatened. Global warming can cause a large part of the polar bear population to find difficult to get food. So how they survive about that? Because of global warming, they cannot get food. To look further, of course, this research will take a lot of time, because it only focus of an existing journal reports or website or the data. Of course, by taking advantage of this, the cost of the conducting research will be very cheap. With these two different cases, I think critically about which journals, website or reports have more data. Of course, there is so much data that will burden the mind, but in that way I can find out and get a new information about the polar bears and the factor that cause the polar bear population to decrease. Report that have been made will be checked a second time to ensure that the content of the reports are correct as I expected or not. In case like this, it takes long to see the existing situation and condition. Moreover, climate change and global warming cannot be measured by feelings. Technology are needed to assist the research. By using technology, we can make sure about the climate change and global warming and maybe help the population of the polar bear. I don't know. That is from me. That is my personal opinion about this case. Thank you for listening. Have a good day.